2018 Harley-Davidson Sport Glide, first ride. I thought my Harley-Davidson days were over after I wrote a review of the 48 that was, perhaps, less than glowing. I figured that the HD folks would have crossed me off their list of journalists to test ride their bikes. I was a lost cause, so move on. Apparently I was wrong. Both Ride Apart director Chris Cope and the HD team wanted to give me another shot on one of the new Softails, a 2018 Sport Glide to be specific, and I was more than willing. To be honest, the 48 didn't leave a bad taste in my mouth so much as it left a meh taste. It was my very first impression of a real Harley, and I was disappointed that I didn't care for the bike that much. I hope the resurrected 2018 Sport Glide had the potential to redeem my opinion of Harley-Davidson's. That said, these bikes will never be as fun as riding a sport bike, so Harley doesn't need to even try to throw that impression at folks like myself. Or so I thought. As I mentioned earlier, I had a lot of preconceived biases/judgments when approaching this bike. One of them was related to ergonomics, which was one of my bigger complaints about the 48. When I hopped on the bike, the first thing I noticed was the controls. Just like the 48, each handlebar control cluster has a button that operates the self-canceling turn signals. I also noticed that the single gauge is mounted on the 5 US gallon tank, 18.9 liters, as opposed to on the handlebars or in a permanent fairing mount, and gives you information like RPM, time, fuel level, etc. The other thing that I thought was pretty neat was the keyless ignition system. Throw the key fob in your jacket and you're able to start the bike up with the push of a button. It also has a self-setting alarm, which activates when you walk away with the key, and cruise control. If I had to pick one word to describe these features, it would be luxurious. I've never ridden a bike with all these features before. The second thing I noticed was how well the bike fit me. It's difficult to say more than that, it just fit. When I took it off the kickstand, it felt perfectly fine, not overly heavy at all. What helped with the weight was the low, 25.7-inch seat height. Also, the bike has a narrower primary drive and shorter swing arm, which made throwing a leg over it even easier. Taking off was easy, too, since this time around I was familiar with the Harley riding position from my time with Dorothy, the nickname I gave the 48 I rode. The Sport Glide is an easy bike to control, the clutch and brake controls were easy to reach and the mirrors placed perfectly. Overall, I was pleased. This bike was a breeze to maneuver around city streets. I figured the engines in these bikes wouldn't really provide an exciting ride. Adding to that concern was knowledge of the famous Harley Rumble. The Milwaukee manufacturer ensures that its engines have a certain amount of character that you can feel when sitting at a stoplight. My last ride on a Harley involved a lot of shaking, and I wasn't a fan. The Milwaukee 8-powered Sport Glide's vibration, though, did not annoy me. Hallelujah. But how can this be? For the Softail lineup, HD added tuned dual counterbalancers to get rid of primary vibration at idle. At this point, I was very content as I had a bike that fit me well and didn't aggressively vibrate while riding or at idle. How could this get this better? By getting on the throttle and having the thing take off, of course. With just a small twist of the wrist, the Sport Glide lurches forward thanks to its Milwaukee 8107 engine with 108 ft-lb of torque. That small movement produced a big smile. The Sport Glide has a pretty stiff chassis due to the rigid mounted engine. This, along with the non-adjustable 43mm inverted forks, makes for a good front end feel while going through the corners. Even though the Sport Glide has a single disc front brake which doesn't provide enough braking power if you're bombing into a corner, adding the rear brake is enough to get the bike to slow down when need be. As for the rear suspension, the Sport Glide is equipped with an all-new mono shock with remote hydraulic preload adjustment. You can set it using a knob below the right side cover of the bike, which is extremely convenient. Prior to getting on the one chosen for me, Director of Product Planning Paul James set its suspension to the lowest setting. Combined with decent front suspension, This helped settle the bike when I hit some rough pavement. I was bracing myself for the teeth-chattering thud I thought I would encounter, but the Sport Glide smoothed those out surprisingly well. We rode for a total of 80-ish miles up and down Mount Baldy before calling it a day. As we rolled into the parking lot, I had a number of good and confusing feelings happening all at once. I mean, I was never out to hate this bike, but I was actually a bit surprised that I liked it as much as I did.